Hi, it's me again, Guido from Wacom, and in this short video clip I will guide you through the installation of your Wacom Intuos tablet, which I've here on the table, and I will show you the installation process on the Macintosh operating system. This is a bit different from a Windows operating system because of the advanced security settings of macOS, but no worries, I will guide you through the installation process now step by step. Okay, first I start by opening the Wacom website and download the latest driver version. So I go to www.wacom.com, click on support, and here it gives me directly as the first option to drivers menu and downloads. Click on here, and then I can either enter my product name to find the proper driver, but make it easy here, just scroll down a bit. Looking for the latest driver, which is here on the left. It's a driver version which is from the end of January. Click download. Yes, I confirm my download, and the download will take place in a few seconds. After the download, I can close my web page here. I will double click on the installer file, and after some verifying by the operating system, it goes into the Wacom tablet window. Here I click again on the Wacom icon, install Wacom tablet, and then it will guide me to the installation process. Okay, I agree, and now I have to enter my credentials, so my password, because it needs admin rights for installation, but only this one single time. Now it's writing files, it's running the scripts. Okay, and after a few seconds, now it is important, a window is coming up. Let me close the Wacom Desktop Center for a second. It's the accessibility access message from the operating system, from the macOS. And here it's asking me to give special preferences or special settings to the Wacom driver. And this is very important to have the tablet working properly. So what I do here is I click on Open System Preferences. And now the system preferences open in security and privacy, and the accessibility tab is already highlighted. What I have to do now is I have to click on the lock to make changes to this one. Again, enter my credentials, and then another very important step, I see the Wacom symbol and the com.wacom.io manager, which is not checked here. So I go with my cursor and check this one. Enabling this one, allowing the Wacom I/O manager to control the access to my computer, and then I can click on the lock and we are done with the security settings. Now I can close the installer package, and what will happen is that the Wacom Desktop Center will pop up. My tablet is now already working properly. My Intuos Bluetooth here is shown in the Wacom Desktop Center, and I continue now with registering my Wacom tablet to get access to the free software offer.